visible properly. Okay. Yes, good afternoon to all of you. I want to take your attendance first. Yes, good afternoon. Phulmoni is there? Jennifer? Not. Meghna? Meghna, are you there? Good afternoon, yes. Meghna, are you there? Just tell me that yes, ma'am, or not. Meghna? Meghna, are you there? Roshni? Sanjeevani? Sanjeevani? Okay. Shritama, just tell me yes or no. Shritama? Shritama, are you there? Yes, okay. Shomshubhra, are you there? Shomshubhra? Then Shomita, Shomita Sinha. If you're there, just write yes, miss. Shomita Sinha. Roshni has joined, no? Shomita Sinha, okay. Shrija. Shrija. Shrija Chatterjee, just write yes or no, whatever it is. Yes, okay. Naina, Naina is there? No. Rimi is there. Rimi has joined. Rimi has joined. Where is Rimi? Rimi, are you there? Just write yes or no. Rimi, are you there, Rimi? I've seen Rimi joining. Yes or no, Rimi? Where are you? Just give me one notification that you have joined or not. Rimi left. Why, Rimi, where are you? Rimi, give me one notification. Okay. Anyone else who has joined? Just give me one notification that you have joined. Anyone else, please? Okay. Who, what, ma'am, I am present. Rimi, no? Okay. I was doing on the we were doing with the chapter on rights. Yes, I have marked you present, Rimi. We have done till Meghna. Yes, Meghna, I have marked you present. Okay. I have done on Thursday last. I have done like on. Who is this one? Ma'am, I'm present. That is Rimi, no? Rimi, no? That you have written, ma'am, I'm present. Who is this one? Rimi, to? Who is that? Brishti, sorry. Brishti, actually, I could not understand your name. Brishti, no? Brishti. Okay, Brishti, I've done it for you. Phulmoni is not there, no? Phulmoni is there? Okay. Phulmoni, Jennifer. Then, Shomshubhro. Shomshubhro. Then, Shomita. Shomita, are you there? Shomita, are you there? If you're there, just give me one notification, yes or no. Shomita Sinha. Okay. Okay. Naina is not there. Then Brishti, Rimi is there and Brishti is there. Okay, I have marked present. So I have done last Friday, Thursday, I have done up till kinds of rights, and I have told you that if it is possible, then do write it in the form of like types, as it is not given in your books. Just write it in the name, in subtitles like natural rights, political rights, social rights, economic rights, civil rights, and legal rights. Clear? Just put the subheadings and then describe it. Okay, now comes rights and responsibilities. Now we will see that, you know, we claim for rights. Rights means, as I've told you, claims. Claims are your demands, what you owe to the state or what you owe to the government, or in another words, I can tell you what you demand. What you demand from your government. Clear? But together with that, children, it is not possible that always we will have only rights. You know, together with rights, what we should have is that we should have certain responsibilities. And as you know that it is quite often said that rights and responsibilities are the two opposite sides of the same coin. Clear? So it is not at all, I'll say that it is not always that you will only claim for rights. But you must also have certain responsibilities or obligations. What are they? You see, firstly, it is on page number 75, third line, you are getting it. Firstly, they means rights, compel us to think not just of our own personal needs and interests, but to defend something as being good for all of us. This is very, very true. That means, while claiming for rights, you should not always think that what is good for me. We should also think that what is good for all, because if it is good for all, remember, then it will be good for the entire nation and the entire country. As for example, one example is given here, like the depletion in the ozone layer. if I think that I am not responsible for ozone depletion, so why should I take up the responsibility? But if, when we come to see that when, what happens after the ozone layer is getting depleted, what will happen? Ultraviolet rays will penetrate inside. So will it happen like this, that ultraviolet rays will go and affect only those people, those who have caused harm to the environment? Will it be like that? No. When the harmful effects will start, it will start upon all of us, not one or only those people, those who have actually caused harm to the environment. So whenever we are claiming of rights, we should not be selfish. We should not think of only ourselves or only of our personal benefits. We have to think for the personal, we should think for the benefit of all the others. Secondly, they require that I respect the rights of others. Here you say that, this is very important, very, very important. I say that if you want that others should respect your rights, it is also necessary that you should also respect the rights of others. Because if you don't respect the rights of others, nobody will come to respect your rights, isn't it? This is a give and take business, give and take. If you give me respect, I will give you respect. If you try to protect my right, I will try to protect your right. Thirdly, we must balance our rights when they come into conflict. That means when I am using my right, if I find that my use of right is coming in a conflict with the use of other person's right, then what we have to do? We have to balance the situation. And this balancing can be done not by fighting, remember. We have to go for negotiation, adjustment, things like that. For example, if I say that, see, in your house, there is a celebration, and what you have done, you know, you have used a microphone and you are playing the songs at a high volume. But there, the one, because you say that this is my right, I can do this. But maybe there is someone beside your house, there is a patient and who needs a rest. Clear? If that person comes and tells you that please lower the voice of this sound because there is a patient in my house and I need to, what you will do? That time will you say that no, go, you do whatever, this is my right and I can do it? You cannot do this, because when I use my rights, I have to remember that I should not harm the rights of others. So there must be a perfect balance. This is what rights responsibilities actually teach us. Fourthly, citizens must be vigilant about limitations which may be imposed on their rights. This is very, very important. This is also very important. You have to be vigilant. Vigilant means you have to keep a watch. Vigilance means watch. That if I am using this right, it's okay that you know about your rights. Together with that, you have to know that what are the restrictions imposed on the use of this freedom or this right of mine. Clear? As for the third example, I was telling you that you will play the sound box at a very loud pace and you will not think of the others. That cannot be done, because your rights are your own rights. It should not be a cause of destruction or harm for the others. There should be a perfect balance. Balance in the sense of what? Where you can also use your rights, together with that, the others also can use those rights. As for example, you have heard about the second fundamental right, right to freedom. If for example I say that right to life, if you think that I have right to life, I have right to live properly, safely, and every now and then you say that I will kill that person, I will put that person behind bars. Why? Because I am feeling a danger from that person. That cannot be done. If you have a right to live, that person, another one also has a right to live. So you must have to know about that if I am using this particular freedom or right? What are the obligations? Obligations means what are the limitations or responsibilities which come along with that particular right. As for example, you have right to freedom of speech and expression. You say that I have right to freedom of speech and expression, and at times you use such vulgar words, unconstitutional words, which may hurt the sentiments of others. You cannot do this. And when you say that, yes, I have right to freedom of speech and expression, and I can use any kind of word I want, no. Because it is very well mentioned that when you are using your freedoms, your rights, you should use it for your own benefit, which means that you cannot harm it either physically or psychologically. You cannot harm the others. Clear? So these are the four obligations or four responsibilities which you should keep in your mind while using your freedom. Am I clear? With this, we come to an end with this chapter on rights. So I'll give you questions. Get ready for the questions, children. Are you ready? Are you ready, children? Okay, right. What are rights? This will be for 1 mark. If it is for 1 mark, then you will write just claims or demands. What are rights? This can come for 1 mark also. This can come for 2 marks also. If it is a 2 mark, then you will have to write a few more sentences. But if it comes as a 1 mark, that is objective, then it can be your claims or demands. Next one. What are the greatest source of rights? This will be for 1 mark. If it is for 1 mark, you will have to write the constitution. If it is for 4 mark, then you will have to write it from page number 89, where you are 69, where you are getting those part. Where do rights come from? Clear? Next one, who has put forward the concept of idea of moral conception of rights, one mark, and it is the German philosopher Immanuel Kant. Now next, for Kant only I will tell you. What are the arguments put forward by Kant, K-A-N-T, Kant, in support of moral conception of rights. Question mark. This will be for 4 marks, and page number 70 you are getting them. You see last paragraph, that block which is given, page number 70. Next one, how many kinds of rights are there? How many kinds of rights are there? This will be for 6 marks. Next one, what are the responsibilities or obligations which come along with rights? Question mark, this will be for 4 marks. If any one or two questions, tomorrow I will make you write, and I suppose only one more chapter is left, that is development. I will start it tomorrow, and within this week I will complete the syllabus. Okay, thank you very much, children.
Yes, bye-bye.